So on this belt line is a legal punch. Anything here will be legal. I want a good, clean fight. Protect yourself at all times and touch them up. Scoop back.
We certainly always love to see this, Barack. Two prospects with 8 and 6 fights, respectively, match tough at this stage in their career. Two prospects from different promotional bodies as well. Of course, this happens, but we would always love to see it more often.
This must have been an accident.
Round one underway. Aaron Aponte and Fernando Molina. See Aponte in the red trunks, trimmed with gold, with the Alien King logo on the waistband. Fernando Molina in the white trunks, Mexican colors throughout, with the yellow tassels.
The difference in height is it's not as bad as I thought it would look. What about you?
Well, I think that it, you know, Aponte's kind of dipping at the knees a little bit, maybe to level himself out and land some of those body shots like that as they trade. Good exchange there between Aponte and Molina.
I've seen Aponte before fight tall, fight long, fight from long distance. That's why this surprised me.
Well, remember, as we mentioned, Aponte's team specifically requested Molina as the opponent here. They said that they felt that after watching Molina's bouts, particularly his most recent one against Ricardo Valdovinos, they feel that he's unable to make adjustments. And that once they get him past round three, Aponte's team feels that Molina's just going to run out of ideas. Good shot there from Aponte, leaping into the left hook.
Aponte is one of those kids that, like Zab Judah in the amateurs, had a lot of knockouts. Usually guys that even have knockouts in the pros didn't have a lot of knockouts in the amateur rankings.
Good shot there from Molina, a left hook that landed high on the head of Aponte. Molina certainly throwing his shots with conviction here in the early going. Steps in with a jab to the body. Aponte looking for that right hand. Certainly doesn't hide the fact that his bread and butter is that straight right hand, as you might expect for an orthodox fighter with his dimensions in this weight class.
Yeah, absolutely. And also, it's different from the McKinley Herrera fight, where you can see where one is more dominant from the beginning. One is the A side, one is the B side. These two look evenly matched.
Shot to the body there from Molina. There's some sneaky work to the body again from Molina. Both fighters definitely having their moments here in round one. Good counter left hook. Aponte landed there. He sensed a pattern, I think, from Molina flurrying to the body and just waited for his opportunity to land that left.
Yeah, but I think it's smart for Molina to be going to the body this early. Oh, there goes the mouthpiece.
Terrific opening round between these two undefeated prospects.
Shop O'Reilly Auto Parts from your phone and pick up your parts in store or have them shipped to you. Get the parts you want, how you want them, with O'Reilly Auto Parts.
Round two begins. This one's scheduled for 8. Aaron Aponte and Fernando Molina. As it projected on paper, a very well-matched contest here. Aaron Aponte won 5 national championships. Fernando Molina won a junior national championship in Mexico, as well as an array of state and regional championships as well.
I thought I'd see more of that, and that's Aponte using his reach with that jab. He double jabbed, another double jab there.
Lena looking for more body work. Aponte trying to lean back and counter with a left hook once again.
Yeah, now we're seeing a different Aponte. You're seeing one who, if he's going to attack, he's going to attack from long range, and he's going to counter. He's not going to stay in there and bang like he was doing in the first round.
Molina just trying to work his way to the inside. This is another element of Aponte's game that he was talking about. You know, that spring in his step and utilizing some of the athleticism, but mixing it with a little bit of pro polish.
Being the taller fighter, usually taller than everybody, you usually don't see that. So I know he does look like an alien to everybody when they're across the ring from him.
Aponte maybe getting a little too playful there. Gets cracked with a right hand from Molina. Molina again with a right hand, and now he's feeling a little looser. See the hands at the side of Molina as well. Both men building confidence here in the second round.
Oh, there goes a headbutt. And Aponte gave him a little smile, and you know what that means. It means, yeah, you caught me. Good shot. See, I think we've been 2 minutes in, and Aponte has forgot that he started off the round with a great jab.
Another body shot there from Molina. Climbs the ladder with a left hook as well. And a right hand comes over the top. Oh, Molina thought about a shot behind the head. Thankfully thought better. We're inside the final 30 seconds of this round, and the tempo really picking up as Molina hits the canvas.
That was not a knockdown.
Right, that looked like a balance issue. We'll look at it on replay. It looked like Molina had actually landed the better shot in that exchange.
Exactly.
But the judges will be forced to score it as it was officiated. Let's take a look at the replay here. I mean, again, in real time, it looked like the feet got tangled, but...
Did you see a punch land by Aponte? I saw a great punch landed by Molina, and they were body to body, and we need a different angle.
So potentially a very tough break for Molina there. But officially it is a knockdown scored by Aaron Aponte in round two. As round three begins.
Let's see how this makes Molina react, you know, being down 10-8 already.
Good shot there again. And Molina, you know, maybe that was basically the same sequence. Like, he almost lost his own balance throwing so hard. And hits the floor once again. That one, luckily for him, not scored a knockdown. A little combination there from Molina. Aponte not using his jab as actively as he did in round two.
Yeah.
Aponte takes a good body shot. Aponte almost mirroring the approach of Molina right now, just jumping in with hard body shots.
I think in the beginning of the round, Aponte was missing some shots. Molina was kind of showing off his head movement, his foot movement. And Aponte said, okay, I got something for you. I'm going to go to the body.
Closing in on the final minute here of round three. Both Aponte and Molina with good moments in this round, but that right hand connects from Aponte. You know he's hunting for that. That's definitely not a secret. He and his camp very open about that, and now Aponte starting to open up.
He does say that's his money shot. He just got to set it up with the jab, you know, because Molina knows it's coming.
For a counter uppercut.
You see now Aponte, remember he was had that spring in his step. He was on his toes. Now he's flat-footed because I think he wants to, you know, land some power shots.
Aponte showing some different looks here. It certainly felt like, despite the knockdown, it felt like maybe there was some momentum heading towards Molina, but Aponte with a terrific finish to this round.
Had to be called super fights. This is one of them.
There's a score to settle.
I can even test your battery, alternator, check engine light, and more.
Back live here in Las Vegas as we take a look at the corner of Fernando Molina. A family affair for him. You see Baltazar Molina, his father, Alexis Molina, his brother in his corner. Across the ring from him, Aaron Aponte's father, Reniel Aponte, also in the corner with Michael Robles. So round four begins. Back and forth matchup between two undefeated prospects. A debatable knockdown in round two, certainly looming large at this point. But even despite the knockdown, as we were doing, discussing in round three, it felt like maybe Molina was starting to build a little bit, get some momentum, but Aponte really closed out round three very well.
Yeah, and I think that's just a testament to him being able to adjust what he said he learned in the amateur ranks. You know, I'm tall, I'm long, I can fight on the inside and the outside. And that's what I think he did. He adjusted. Molina's getting a little bit more brave with the leaping left hooks, a la Roy Jones Jr.
But going back to what Aponte's corner told us, Aponte and his team, as another clash of heads. It's been an epidemic so far here on our broadcast. It ended our first fight. As we were saying, this is around the time that Aponte thought that Molina would start to wither, but look at this. It's the time he's turning it on. Molina all over Aponte, who's on wobbly legs. Another right hand rains in.
Corey, I think Aponte already recovered.
Molina certainly emboldened by what he saw. We'll see if Aponte could gather himself here. You're right, his legs, at least right now, well, they look more stable than they did before, and Aponte still firing back.
That looks like a man that recovered right there, that combination.
Yeah, good left hook from Aponte, but Molina comes in behind another right hand. Both these men put in a 50-50 matchup for the first time in their careers, and this is what we discussed. This is why you want matchups like this against prospects.
this is definitely going to prepare both of them for their future careers. I just think that Aponte should go back to the jab. He shouldn't be having this tough of a fight with a guy that's that much shorter than him. Not to say that Molina's not good, but he's just short, and he should be fighting from long range.
Molina sneaking an uppercut in there as well. Aponte has managed to recover, but a statement round for Fernando Molina. Aponte in the previous round. There's the clash of heads early in the round. And here it is.
They actually both landed at the same time, but Molina's was just flush.
You gotta tell. You gotta tell.
Time. Let's go. Round five begins, and Aaron Aponte certainly had some degree of difficulty with Leon Martinez in his last fight, but nothing like what he just experienced in round four. He hurt and wobbled for the first time in his career. There's a right hand again. Aponte lands one, so does Molina.
You know, this is just a night of chips on shoulders because they both actually coming off of split decision victories in their last outings.
Hard right hand to the body from Molina. Aponte landed one of those about 10 seconds ago as well.
This is a great fight by two young prospects, both undefeated.
Uppercut there from Molina. And a wobbly step again from Aaron Aponte, who gets rocked with a left hook.
Oh, he's really hurt now, Corey.
Aponte in serious trouble right now. He is getting battered around the ring. Another left hook connects from Molina. An eternity of time for Molina to work with. Can Molina capitalize here? Aponte still very unsteady.
Aponte showing a lot of toughness right now because that was a flush uppercut and he ate a couple of right hands.
This is the matchup that they specifically asked for, but it is certainly not going the way that they had anticipated.
It's a really good left hook by Molina there.
Mouthpiece out now from Molina. And that will buy Aponte some additional time. Brock, what do you think right now? How do you evaluate this? Is Molina taking his time and being patient, or is he being too patient?
No, I think that Aponte is still throwing hard shots. I mean, yes, he was wobbled. Yes, he was hurt, but he kind of gained his footing. And look, see, he's swinging hard for the fences. So Molina's saying, I still got to be careful.
We've seen guys like Joyce, perhaps.
Right.
Molina.
Yeah, we've seen guys like Sergio Mora knock down Danny Jacobs because coming in too crazy after you hurt the guy.
Final 30 seconds of a round that it looked for a while like Aponte might not make it out of it. And another right hand lands from Molina. An uppercut and a chopping right behind it. Down goes Aponte. Aponte with some steps that looked a little unsure towards the referee, but time is on his side here as round five will come to an end. And let's take a look at the replays here, Brock.
Aponte landed a really good hand that did not faze Molina at all. But it was that uppercut right there. It was the right uppercut by Molina that really hurt Aponte. There it is. Wobbled him down. And I'm glad he caught himself because he could have landed another shot with momentum.
Round six underway. Fernando Molina putting Aponte on the canvas for the first time. Aponte has been hurt in two consecutive rounds now. Molina was technically on the canvas in round two. So if we do go to the scorecards, that'll factor in. But there's no question which way the pendulum is sitting right now. Again, a matchup that Aponte and his team specifically asked for. Probably not going the way that they forecasted.
No, not at all. And Molina on paper even up the score with that knockdown, but the only difference is that Aponte is actually hurt. Molina was never hurt.
Well, it was Aponte who was lauded as the budding power puncher in this matchup. But right now, it's Molina who has done more damage by a wide margin.
That's a very good point. And it's just something to say about a properly placed punch, you know, that really gets you out of there.
Another counter right hand from Molina connects. Aponte still at this point. There he offers a jab, but Rocky's doing a lot of moving right now. But I think it's safe movement. He's not offering a whole lot. He looks to me like a fighter who's still recovering.
Yeah, but as a fighter, as a taller fighter, you could still be at least feinting, throwing a couple jabs, even if they're lazy jabs and you're keeping your distance not to get hit, just to let your fighter know I'm still in this. Don't just show him that I'm hurt and I'm avoiding you.
Just missing with that right hand. There's a nice right hand to the body from Aponte, who's sporting something between swelling and a cut underneath his right eye.
I think Aponte is really good at masquerading how hurt he really is.
I mean, this is certainly a courageous effort from Aponte. He hasn't experienced this at any point in his career. Hard body shot from Molina. Aponte trying to stand in there and counter now.
We got two rounds left. Depending on how the judges have it scored, Aponte still has a chance to, you know, pull off a victory.
Take a look at the corner of Fernando Molina. Excuse me, it's Darren Aponte's corner. His father, Reniel Aponte. The situation they have yet to be in. See Jacob Stitch Duran also in the corner of Aponte. A handy man to have around when there's an abrasion under your eye. One of the best in the business. So we'll see how Aaron Aponte reacts here in round seven. You made a good point in round six, Brock, which is that this fight is not out of reach for Aponte at all.
I think it's just about Aponte picking the right style to finish off this fight, which is long distance. There you go. Jab. Just like that.
Well, right hand connects there from Aponte. I think Aponte now realizing he can't just move at this point. This is a fight that is not out of reach. And he certainly has the power that if he can stand in there and counter with those uppercuts and that right hand, it's not out of the question that he could hurt Molina as well. But Molina with a beautiful uppercut on the inside.
I think he found the punch. I think he found the punch. That's the punch that hurt him earlier, and I think he's trying to land it again. But if Aponte was fighting at long distance, that would never land.
You see some blood coming from the mouth of Fernando Molina as well, and some tape loose, which we'll get tended to as well.
It should be 8 ounces.
Molina has his foot on the ropes. He's like, I'm going to really rest right now. You might as well just sit down on the ropes. Where's his corner? I see the ref doing something, but where's his corner? If there's something wrong with the glove.
You see some Aaron Aponte fans in the first row as well, giving some additional instructions.
This might be a bigger issue than just tape, because I don't know why.
Yeah, we're taking a look at the surface of the glove here, but no, looks like the referee's gesturing to maybe rewrap it. Let's see.
Because he brought him to a neutral corner. Yeah, maybe the stitching ripped in the glove. Because they're taping it now.
Okay, that's good. Stop it.
I mean, very unusual to see this, but also, I mean, that creates an abrasive surface on the outside of the glove, doesn't it? That's
it does, and it can also scratch. Yeah, it can scratch it. I've never seen that happen before.
So an extremely unusual circumstance here. We'll see how it affects both fighters. We'll see if we might be able to get word from down ringside when it comes to that decision.
Well, one thing I can say to Aponte, just had a nice time to recover, catch his wind, and now he's back on that jab.
Good exchange there on the inside. Both men trading left hooks. Good right hand over the top from Molina again. And a nice flurry that ends with a left hook on the inside from Molina. Now Aponte taking a step back and gets driven back to the ropes. Good work there from Molina. Brock, you pointed out that maybe Aponte would come out of that break refreshed. Whatever momentum was there, Molina just took it right away. Now Molina turns the tables and tries to flurry.
We heard a muscle memory. Well, I think there's uppercut memory. I think it's just lingering damage that Molina caused on Aponte.
I mean, supposing we get to the corner at the end of round seven. Oh, look at that. A nice right hand from Aponte. It's the shot that he's been looking for all fight long. That's why I posed the question, if we make it to the end of the round, it'll be interesting to see what happens with the glove of Molina. Do they swap it out for a spare? Do they let him fight like this? A very unusual circumstance here in the midst of a terrific fight between two undefeated prospects, trading shots now in the center of the ring. We'll take a look at some of the replays from round seven.
Oh, beautiful inside work by Molina. Combination starting with the uppercut, of course, and left hook. And Aponte showing his grit as well with his combinations. Just landed a great right hand at the end of the punch after Molina slipped the other two punches before that. Molina has to be confident right now, especially his corner, you know, going into this round.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the eighth and final round.
The eighth and final round of an action-packed bout between Aaron Aponte and Fernando Molina. Both men have touched the canvas, although the knockdown of Aaron Aponte much more consequential, as he was badly hurt after that and was hurt in the previous round as well. But again, not necessarily a fight that's out of the reach of Aaron Aponte, depending on how round seven was scored and depending on what happens here in the final 3 minutes.
Agreed. And I see rising prospect Xander Zayas watching. And, you know, he's probably a little concerned for Aponte. That was a great shot by Aponte there. Well, one thing we can see is Aponte's back on his toes. Back on his toes, trying to be long again. Feinting, jabbing. That jab connected right before that one.
Now, one thing we have to point out, I mean, this is a 5'6" fighter against a 6-foot fighter. And Molina really hasn't been bothered by the jab of Aponte, either because Aponte hasn't been offering it all that much, or because Molina has done a good job slipping it or just stepping out of the way of it when it has been thrown.
Right. He's not throwing it enough, I would say. And a flickering jab doesn't necessarily hurt, but enough flickering jabs. Whoa.
Ooh, another right hand connects from Molina as Aponte now taking a backward step once again, now trying to circle out and create some distance. Molina, another terrific right hand, and places one now along the belt line.
I just don't understand why Aponte's even letting him in that space. He knows how to dance. He knows how to move. We got 1 minute left to really capture this fight.
Final minute of the contest. And Fernando Molina having himself another terrific round as Aponte is doing a lot of moving right now, but if you're in Aponte's corner, do you not want him hunting for something big here in the eighth, considering that these scorecards could be all over the place?
Yeah, of course. I mean, you would be telling him to use the jab, not just move. Oh, that was a nice slip and uppercut there that Aponte landed on Molina.
Looks like Molina snuck a shot in there as well, as he is all over Aponte, who's trying to roll with these shots along the ropes with 20 seconds remaining in the contest. Final 10 seconds.
There's nothing wrong with jabbing and jabbing and winning a round with a jab, especially if you've been hurt already.
Both men try to flurry at the bell, and that was a terrific fight between two undefeated prospects. Again, we mentioned it off the top. This is why you want prospects at this stage in their career matched with one another.
Yes, there was no surprise here. These guys were matched like this purposely, and we got what we expected, a great fight.
Team Aponte got what they asked for and perhaps a little bit more in this matchup. Team Molina on the shoulders of Baltazar Molina as we take a look back. Right hand from both Aponte and Molina, but it's Molina who stayed in there at the end of the exchange and landed that bonus left hook.
Yes, and it just seems like the more damaging shots was by Molina, you know, even though they both land at the same time.
The body language very different in these corners right now. This corner, Fernando Molina's corner, looks like a team that believes they've won. I don't know that I could say the same about Aaron Aponte.
It's definitely the winner's circle over here in the red corner. You can see the father of Aponte. He doesn't look too enthused, doesn't look too happy. Understands that his son was in a tough fight, but there's always hope.
And again, credit to Aponte, not just for taking the fight, but for requesting it.
Well said.
Aponte. No, a very interesting young man to talk to, very intelligent young man. We'll see if he will retain his undefeated record. Looks like the decision is in. We can send it down to the center of the ring to David Diamante.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 8 rounds of action here at the T-Mobile Arena, Las Vegas, Nevada, we go to the judges' score totals. They read as follows. Ricardo Ocasio, 76-74 for Fernando Molina. Chris Migliori, 76-74, Adam Aponte. And Don Trella scores this bout. 75-75, we have a split draw.
So a split draw, and I'm sure supporters of Fernando Molina are going to have a lot to say about that decision, Brock.
Oh, that's a tough one. It's a tough one because, you know, when you're watching the fight from where we're at ringside, it's like we're not able to score the fights round per round. But if this was a fight on the street, we know who won. And that's the thing. And it's like maybe they each won the equal amount of rounds, but one was punished more, and that one who was punished is Aponte.
A gutsy effort from Aaron Aponte to eke out a draw. A terrific fight between Molina and Aponte as advertised. Plenty more action still to come here from the T-Mobile Arena. Next up in the ring, it'll be Mark Castro and